its E30, E36, E46, and E90 generations, is now the ultimate synthesis of the brand's engineering might and dynamic credentials. And if the criteria are that the car be capable of captivating through not only its handling and racy visuals, but also brain-liquefying performance, then there's no doubt that this DCT-equipped M3 is the pinnacle of the breed. Numbers game. The numbers are indeed astonishing. 60 mph from arrest. Dispatched in 3.8 seconds. 0 to 100 mph. Consider it done in 8.5. The quarter mile. 12 flat at a scorching 119 mph. Stopping. It's a master at that, too, decelerating from 70 mph in a tidy 153 feet. The M3 also grips a skid pad like Shell Silverstein's UPYUK, holding on for 99 centimos. These numbers, it must be noted, are just one rung down from those of cars costing 3 to 4 times as much, and the 1.9, second 30, 2, 50, mph passing time actually ties the figure we recorded with the Lamborghini Huracan. Midrange grunt, the M3 has it. However, we report those figures with something slightly less than glee. It's not that the car isn't breathtaking to experience, because it is. It's not that it doesn't still feel special, because it does. It's that the M3 posts its numbers with less involvement and joy than it once did. Yes, the M3 has fully embraced its digital side, as exemplified by its having up to 9 chassis settings, 3 each for the powertrain, suspension, and steering plus, in this automatic equipped model, another 6 modes for the transmission. There are also various stability control programs. This is all probably necessary to deliver the scintillating numbers, if there can be such a thing, but dialing in the car for your particular taste has never been so easy or so perplexing, which forces us to ask, whatever happened to BMW being the taste maker, delivering one perfect chassis tune and allowing you to discover its nuances?